Hi, in today's session we will discuss about the modules. Okay, what is the meaning of module? Module or package, anything, whatever you know.
Like functions can be used, like packages, we can import the package and we can use it anywhere.
Okay. Correct. Okay. Assume we all are working in the same project. Whatever you write in the functions, I want to reuse it without writing again. It need not be in the same file. Okay, across the files I can use it, the same functions. Then we will go for the modules. Functions we will write to reuse within the same file. Okay, the same functions, if we make it as a module, we can reuse it in other modules also, other files also. Here the concept of module was each individual file we are calling as a module in Python. We will see how to use it. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Now, first we will see what are the advantages of module. What you are doing? We are logically organizing the code in the module. In each file, what you will keep? Related code we will keep. Okay. In the module, what you will do, we can define a variable, you can define a classes, you can define a functions. Okay, whatever you define in a module, we can reuse in other files. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay, here we will follow two steps. First one is we will come to know how to use the existing modules. Then we will create our own module and we will try to reuse it.
Okay.
Okay. Python is so famous because of its modules only. More than 1000 modules are there. Okay, we can't learn all the modules. Okay, whatever the mostly used modules we will discuss here.
Okay.
Once if so you there come will be... to know, if you come to know how to use the one module, the same way remaining modules also you can use it. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Someone is asking something.
No, yeah, we can also define the packages or modules, right, in a project.
Yeah, once
our own defined project.
Correct. Once first level step is over, second step is how to define our own modules. I will explain. Okay. First
okay.
thing is
okay.
how to reuse the existing modules. We will come to know. Okay. Now see, right now
dot py.
Okay. We have so many modules are there, right? I am saying, okay, we can take math module. Okay, our simple thing is there, how to use it, we'll see. First statement was, if you want to use the module, use now whenever you import any module, give one print statement after that, means all the modules are imported properly or not. If modules are not imported properly, it will give error. Now I don't have socket module. Oh, it is there. Okay, wait. Socket 123. This module is not there. Okay, if it is not there, it will throw the error. Module was no named module.
Okay.
Whenever you are doing something, okay, in the initial itself, whether it is imported or not, okay, we can check.
Okay, if we don't give a print statement, it won't show an error.
It will show the error. just for understanding. Okay, if print statement is printed, it gives successfully module was
Okay.
imported, but if this it is not showing and some other error means there is some problem while importing the modules.
Important. So without any print statement we cannot find out if that module is there or not.
Without that one also it will give.
Okay.
But and for our understanding we are giving.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Yep.
See here math 1, 2, 3 only. Now see, it is giving error, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now I want to know what are the available functions, right? If you want to use, you have to know, right? What are the available functions in that one?
Yeah.
Okay. First, we'll check what are the functions available in the module.
Math.
What is your module name? Math module.
Math.
Okay. Now, function list equal to, I'm giving dirav math. What it will do was, it will list all the available functions in this module, dirav math.
Okay, okay. It's like math directory, right? It will list all the function of the math directory. Okay.
Correct. Now, I'm printing all the functions. Function list, print,
function name.
Here what I am doing, I am trying to list all the available functions in the module, math module. Because if you want to use means, you have to know first of all how what are the modules are available, what are the functions available in that function module, right?
Yeah.
See, these are the modules I have, these are the functions I have in my math module.
Yeah.
Got it? Acas, Acas H, Asin, all these things I have. Got it?
Yes.
Now we will try to use one of the function. We will take as a factorial and power function.
Okay, we can rewrite those functions, right?
We will use it and we will override the functions in our module. We cannot update the math module. In case of updating is required means we can do it in our own file. We cannot directly update the math source code, okay?
Okay.
We can customize, okay?
Yeah.
Now you know the functions are available. Now I want to use the function. Now we will take as a factorial function. How to use it? Factorial of 5, what the number? Factorial of 5 value. What is it will give?
60.
Okay. What the function? How it will work? Factorial? Tell me.
5 into 4 into
4 into 3 into 20.
3 into 2.
Okay. How come it is 60? It is 120, right?
120.
Yeah. Okay. If I want to use any function in the module, I want to use as a math dot. Module name dot function name. If it is taking any argument, you will use it.
Okay.
Now execute it. Factorial of 5 is 120.
Yeah.
Did we define factorial function?
No.
No. We defined it.
We didn't define, right?
Using the math function. We are just using the math the factorial function in math.
Okay. We didn't define the factorial function. We are importing the existing module and using it. Agree?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, five power three. How much value?
125.
Okay. 125, it came, right?
Yeah.
you are able to use the functions in the existing module. Is it clear?
Yeah.
How you are doing? You are using import math statement and listing down all the functions. This is not a mandatory thing, because for your understanding I did. Okay, what are the available functions in a module?
Yeah.
If you know the functions directly, you can use it. Dot factorial, dot power functions. Agree?
Yes.
This is one way of using the module. Now, I will show another way. Now what I will do was, here you are using math.name, right? You know, I want to use only few functions in that module. You already know, okay, you won't use any other thing. Factorial, comma, power. From math module, import these functions.
Okay.
Otherwise, what it will do was, it will import all the functions. Okay.
Like Java.
Yeah.
Right? Java will import everything, right?
Yeah, correct. From math, import factorial com power. Now, I'm importing only two functions from the math module. Agree?
Yeah.
No need to give here math dot, because those, whatever the functions are there, those functions will come on in here. No need to append the module name for using that one. From math, import factorial com power.
Okay.
Clear? It worked, right?
Yeah.
You did done anything? No, right?
No.
No. Okay. Now, sign off function is there. Now, if I try to use sign off, because it will give undefined function. Sign off 180. It will show undefined function. It is available in the math module, but it is not imported here. Correct?
Yeah.
Then it will throw the error, right? Okay.
Yep.
You can use star means import all the functions.
Everything. Yep.
Import everything into module. Okay.
Yeah.
Now it is showing, right? Got it? If you want to restrict, no need to import all the modules. I want to give use only two functions or three functions, a list of functions. You can restrict the importing of the modules.
Okay.
Using here a statement factorial comma pow. If you want to import all the functions, you can use it like this. Okay?
Okay. Yep.
Whenever you are doing, okay, import math, get all the functions, then check what are the suitable functions to you and import those things. Importing math is nothing wrong. Import star also nothing wrong. If you want to restrict, provide a restrictions, then only you will mention the module function names in the import statement. From math, import function names. Okay.
Yep.
Is it clear? Now you have a confidence, you can do a work on any module. Agree?
Yeah.
I will take some other module. Here we have a functions. Pickle module I will take. Because we are not sure what are the things are there in pickle module. Test mode. Just I am taking another example. Now we'll see what are the available functions there. Okay, these are the functions available in the pickle module. Okay.
Yeah.
Now here we have a dump function in there. Okay. Dot dump off, okay, required a file position do not. Okay, we will take the date time module. Date time. Now, see what are the available functions in the date time module. Now, these are the things available in date time. Now, I want to get the current time. Function was timestamp equal to date time module name dot here I have another thing date time dot now off. This is the function to get the current timestamp. Now I'm getting timestamp now see the value. We are getting the current timestamp, right? Okay.
Yeah.
Using the functions, we can get all the. We can reuse it without writing any functions. This is the way we can use it the modules, math module and date time modules. Okay.
I lost the connection actually. My laptop got switched off suddenly.
Okay. The thing was, what I'm saying was, here we tried with the math module. The same way we can use the other modules also. Date time module I taken.
Okay. Okay.
What are the available functions are there? And we are using one of the function there.
Okay.
Could you just tell me the 17th line properly? Like timestamp is our local variable and date time dot date time.
Okay. Date time is a module name. Inside the module, we have another sub package date time dot now off. Here we are having right.
Okay, date time off date time. Huh?
Yeah. Now.
So inside date time module, there is also date time.
Correct.
Function.
Yeah. Correct.
Okay. Function. What is the dot now? Now is the. Time,
okay. Huh? Inside this one date time. Date time is the class, and this one is a function in that one.
Okay.
Like this we can use it. Clear?
Yeah.
Now we will write our own module. You know how to use it, how to import all the functions or how to restrict the function names. Agree?
Yeah.
Okay. Now I will write our own module. I will write this module as a calculator module. Right? Agree?
Yeah.
Calculator module. Now what is our requirement? We have to write a functions. We are providing two labels, right? Num1, num2. Num1 plus num2. Return result. This is the add function, agree? Now what I will do was, these are the four functions. Whatever, if you provide the result, okay, it will do the operation it will give. Agree? Now I am printing like this, add of 20 comma 30. What is the result? See,
20 comma 30, add
comma 30 comma.
Yeah, you got the result 50. Now we will do one thing. We will do one perform operation. Mean you want to do perform arithmetic operation, right? Here, whenever you invoke perform operation, what is the calculator what you will do? First tell me. Here
will input to,
you will take num1 operator plus num2, right? Equal to, you will do, right? The same thing we will do. Num1 equal to input of enter the number 1. Num2 equal to int of number 2. Agree? Now what we need was, which kind of operator you want to use, right? You want to use operator, right? Provide the operator. Now once you did this thing, print all the details first. You are going to do this kind of operation.
So you are taking input.
Wait.
Zero op.
You are going to perform operator input on rest or plus, all these symbols. Format of what I am giving, num1, comma what is the operator I am doing. Got it? Okay, now I will invoke the function. Just it is incomplete one, just we will see if we are able to print the details or not. Num1 23 24 star I am giving. It is printing right details properly. Now what is the thing you want to do? If you have to compare, right? Operator equal to, if operator equal to plus. What you have to do?
Add the number and number.
You have to invoke the add function.
Add
function.
Yeah.
Num one comma num two. Equal to, agree?
Yeah.
If minus subtract, right?
Yeah.
Subtract.
Multiplication.
Star. Slash div. Agree?
Yeah.
Right now we are handling only four operators. Okay, we can do remaining things later. Else. Invalid operator. Agree?
Yeah.
Okay. Now you are taking and we are doing printing the result. Inside perform operation. Agree? This one?
I have a doubt.
Yeah, 1 second. Okay, wait. This is 4. Yeah, tell me.
How can you call directly add, subtract, multiple and division functions?
You are invoking a function, that's it. You are calling one function inside other function. What is wrong?
Okay, directly we can call. Okay.
Yeah, that is directly we can call. Okay, well, that's what we did. Okay, 1 second. I'll open the function. Okay, here this is the function get grade. I am calling right directly.
Okay, thank you. Okay, got it.
Here you are assigning the same thing you are doing inside another function.
Okay, got it.
Don't confuse, huh?
Yeah, got it.
Okay, now I am calling the function. Now let me do the age equation. What I am doing? Perform operation, right?
Yeah.
23. Okay. 12. I am doing star. Result you are getting, you are able to achieve the calculator, agree?
Yes.
Okay. Any doubts in this one, in this file till now?
No.
Okay, Naveen is there?
Yeah. Actually, I thought like we are writing another function. Now I understood that we are invoking the function in the perform operation.
Yeah, correct. This is one function we are doing, that's it. Okay, now you are clear, we return 1 file. Okay, it is working good, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now I will keep only functions in that one. This is a similar to a module written by a third party. How you are using math, how you we developed our own calculator module. Agree?
Yeah.
Now yeah. What I will do was I am testing the calculator module. You imported math the similar way, we will do our thing, our own thing.
Okay, we will create our own module.
Yeah.
For the calculator.
Because test calculator is a module.
Yeah.
Now, what we will do was import test calculator. What is the, how, you don't know, what are the functions available, how to know the functions?
for function names.
You are giving a name for that and you are passing through for
test calculator and list all the available function.
So whatever we saved the program with a name, that is going to be the module name.
Yeah, correct.
Okay. Yeah.
Now you want to
that is locally available.
Sorry, yeah, carry.
That is locally available to us, right? Yeah, the test calculator is locally available to
us. Yeah, correct, correct.
Okay.
Okay. Now we are seeing test calculator mod.py. Now execute it. It is listing what are the available functions available. You only written, right? Add, div, mul, performs operation, sub operation. These are the functions written by you. Agree? How you are listing third party module, same way you are able to see your own module or not?
Yeah.
Correct? Agree?
Yep.
Okay. Now I will use the module.
Now, how did the perform operation come as a function in that?
Yeah, it is a function only, but def.
So inside a like normally we used to call a function directly, right?
Yeah, you can call it from inside also. You can call it
that
also, nothing wrong.
So it is taking that to
inside another function we are calling it.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, now what I am doing was I am invoking the module test of 2,3 result. Dot add of 2,3. See here, your performance sum operation, add of 2,3, it came. Did you return the add function here inside this file? No, right?
Yeah.
But still you are able to use it?
Yep.
Yes.
Now I will call this one sum perform operation function. Okay, result is equal to test calculator dot perform operation. Now see here, we'll print the result. What are the value you can do? You can do it. See, it is 2,3. Now it is asking for the perform operation because of this one, test perform operation. Agree? We are invoking invoke 34 12, make it divide by
perform. Kalyan, inside perform operation, whatever functions are, like whatever steps are there, that is being executed over here, and
yeah, correct.
At the output, it will ask us if we want add or subtract or something.
Correct. See, yes, simply perform operation is another function. Internally, it will take a num1, num2 and operation. Based on that one, it will perform the invoke the some other function, add, subtract, multiplication, division. It will give the result.
Okay, and perform operation is already there in the test calculator, so we can go, okay, yeah, got
yeah.
it.
Yeah, we can do the result, return result. I have to do here. Okay, now I am doing num1 23 12. I am doing division operation. Got it?
Okay. Yeah, got it.
Are you clear now? We can define our own modules. Agree with this?
Yes.
Are you agreeing or not?
Yes.
Okay. The same way we can review the source code across our project. Okay. If you are developing a new module, it is not at all available, we can share it to the Python community also.
We can develop something and we can share it.
Share to community, Python community also. If it is not specific to your project, it can be used by other person also. Generically, we can share it.
Okay.
Okay.
Are you clear on this?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Now I will do one thing. We will do some more modifications. Okay. I want to use only add and subtract. I don't want to use other functions. What to do?
Directly, we used to call only the functions inside.
That's function.
Okay,
you can
because
call only the function.
In test I am creating another one.
Import import calculation
from calculation.
Yeah.
Import the functions add and subtract.
Yeah.
In test cal.
Import add comma.
Add comma subtract.
Subtract. I cannot use other functions, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
See here. If I use add, it will work fine. If I use perform operation, it will throw the error.
Error.
Yeah, yeah.
See, it is undefined function because I don't know from where I have to get the perform operation definition.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Clear on this?
Yes.
Yeah.
Now I will do import star.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, how to list all the available functions in this module? Whenever you want to do like that, you have to import module name and a debug function we can apply. Agree?
Yeah.
If you want to restrict
yeah.
only few functions only, I have to do import instead of import module name, you can do from module name import specific functions. In this case, no need to prefix with module name. In this case, we have to prefix import math state, import module name is module name dot, you have to use it.
Yeah.
Are you clear on this?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So if you use the star function, we need not use the module name before the function.
Yeah, correct. No need to prefix with module name to invoke the function.
Okay, okay.
Means whatever available things, all the things will come to your module. Means all these are available in your file itself. No need to affix the prefix the module name.
Oh, yeah.
Did you understand properly?
Yeah.